Right, hello there everyone, welcome back to James Redman TV, and you're damn right, Hendo has been replaced with the big dog, Endo fam. The man from Japan, the Japanese Iniesta, the guy who makes friggin' Zinedine Zidane fearful. He is the one, he is the only, he's arrived, he's the dude from Stuttgart, he's the one who's loved in Stuttgart, by the way. I've had loads of Stuttgart fans messaging me, telling me about the legend that is Endo. And it's just been announced by Liverpool Football Club that he's officially our player. €19 million, I believe, is the estimated fee, and then the contract has been officially agreed. They did the full post and stuff like that on Instagram. So he's officially here, no failed medicals to worry about, and we can actually take it into consideration, he could be available for the first game. Again, you know, this is someone who's very reliable, seems to always be in shape, and he's played three seasons back-to-back-to-back, 33 games in a row, and I believe, like, in his last two seasons, he missed, I think it was just two games or something ridiculous like that. So listen, it's someone who's reliable, he's versatile, and to those who are upset about the signing, if you are upset about the overall window and the order of the signings, then I think I understand where you're coming from, because it has been atrocious to many degrees. Where I won't align is that we do still need a midfielder who's versatile, who's a backup, who's happy to not have to play every game. Because Endo could play every game if he's good enough, but if he's not good enough, then I'm sure he's going to be more than content being at Liverpool Football Club on the bench. I think when you consider the course of his career, he started off in Japan, then went to Belgium for a little bit, and then the highest level he's ever played at was Stuttgart, which at best, they're a Bundesliga team who's competing for relegation. I can only really compare them maybe to like a Bournemouth or something like that if they're over here. Stuttgart's a massive team, but you know, I'm just saying that in a sense of where they are in the league at the moment, where they typically rank. I think that's something that we can still question in terms of the level. Is he going to be good going from this level to this level at the age of 30? Fine, but, you know, again, you guys know me. I'm someone who likes to analyse attributes. And I think if you're the best man in a relegation team and now you're going to be around players who are more on your level, great. And I think we've also seen good things on the highest level for Endo. And you're going to go, James, what do you mean? Well, remember Japan's performance in the World Cup? They beat Spain. I believe they beat Belgium as well. It might have been another team, I'm not too sure, but I know they beat two big teams in the course. Germany, that was it. Germany and Spain, I believe it was. They got two victories over those guys, which I think is absolutely massive. And also, a little bit of a fun fact, Endo was the captain for those games. So I'm not here gassing the signing, although I am in the Endo clan. Endo clan, and I have just called him the Japanese Iniesta, you know what I'm saying? And I do genuinely believe, in my heart of hearts, that you get players like Toni Kroos who wear Endo underwear. But listen, I'm just saying that he's an option. And if we don't go and get a CDM, that's now something separate to be upset about. Endo, individually, I think we can be encouraged by the signing. Not from the ownership standpoint, but the player himself. I think he has something to offer, man. You know what I mean? And I understand for those who want league-winning trophies, this isn't one that you're going to be happy with. But he's our player now, so it's one of those where you either back him and see what he does well, or you don't back him and you neglect what he does well. The common factor there is that he does things well and that he can implement things into our team. So whether he plays as a CDM, a centre-back, a left-back, a right-back, it means he can play across the back four. And when we're alternating between the back four and the back three, he can go ahead and slot into those positions as well. So listen, from that standpoint, I'm encouraged. And if he is available for Bournemouth, he's starting as my number six, because I believe Curtis Jones has got an ankle injury, and then Thiago's only just came back from injury. So although Endo is new and he's not too familiar with the team, I think he's one of those. He can come right in, he can get stuck in immediately. Am I a little bit too over ambitious wanting him to start straight away? I don't know. I just want something new in there. Someone who'll actually go in and get stuck in for the tackle. So yeah, that's our James Milner replacement. Hopefully it's not the Fabinho replacement or the Henderson, you know what I mean? Hopefully we'll get one CDM to replace both Henderson and Fabinho, and then this can be the James Milner Neymar replacement, because James Milner was Mr. Reliable, and it seems this dude is as well. But let me know in the comments down below what you think about the signing. He is officially announced up the Endo. And yeah, and I know the fee is one to be questioned as well, by the way, and rightly so, because it is 16 million British pounds. But let's just consider this today's market. It's just one of those, you know, the money's going to keep going up and up and up. And based on a profile sense, it seemed to be someone who we massively needed, because he can cover multiple positions. So if Liverpool felt it was worth paying three times or four times the price, that doesn't sound good, paying three or four times the price for a 30-year-old. But when you consider that Stuttgart really, really wants to keep the player, then you know, I think sometimes you've got to do what you've got to do. So in a sense that we had a player identified, we got the player, at least that's good on this front, but it's just not the player that we were all wanting because we already failed with the likes of Caicedo and Lavia and stuff like this where, you know, we struggled to either get personal terms agreed or maintain personal terms. So yeah, let me know in the comments down below what you're thinking. Does he start against Bournemouth for you tomorrow? And welcome to the club, Enzo Wataru. I think it's Wataru. Big up to Wataru, man. Nice one for watching, guys. Smash a like, subscribe, and I'll see you all later. Peace out.